1,350 those tip tanks that you see on the aircraft, they serve two purposes. One, obviously, carry extra fuel. The second is to act as a fence on the wingtip, which improves the aerodynamic features of the wingtip of the airplane. It was in Korea that these aircraft tip tanks were used as drop tanks, gasoline or napalm in them, to help support the American troops on the ground. Greg says they're too expensive to drop off now.
A beautiful looking aircraft, and one of the last aircraft we'll see today that have the straight wings.
Yes, and we will get into that quite a bit here as we get to talk about it. I hope if the, our spectators have noticed that we're doing the centennial looks right through to the jet age today, and the first flying aircraft. Outside the corner marker and bring the T-33 back to Airshow Center in a photo pass. Make sure you have your shutter speed increased because he's moving a lot faster than that car that pulled the triplane that saw earlier today.
Here on this installation, the Coast Guard flies, the Army flies, Homeland Security has a flying unit on the west side of the base. All of those operations are here represented with their recruiters today, so you can talk with them if you want to fly helicopters. Maybe you talk to the Army or the Coast Guard. If you're interested in something that moves a little faster, you might want to come and talk to the United States Air Force.
Peculiarities of the air conditioning system on the T-33 is it has a propensity in humid climates to spit ice out of the air duct, and most of those that ice hits the pilot in the back of the head and goes right down the back of his flight suit. So keep your scarf tight.
You can see he's got the cockpit open now. It essentially acts as an air brake, acting as similar to a parachute. Catches that air and helps to slow down that aircraft. As we're watching this T-33.